For more than half a century, it was one of Perth's favourite family outings. On a hot summer's night, thousands of West Australians would line the banks of the Swan River to go prawning. Now, scientists are going back to the future to help give new life to a great West Aussie tradition.
It was such a familiar sight. A hot summer's night on the Swan River, dragging a net through the shallows for prawns.
This goes back to what the river used to be and people's connection and family and groups coming down to the river bank, dragging the net through, cooking up the prawns on the bank and spending that time together. And if we can bring that back, then that's just a positive for everyone.
But in recent years, their numbers have been devastated by the changing environment in the river. Now, with the help of science and people power, the prawn is fighting back.
Our goal this year is to get over 1 million prawns restocked in the river. We've had a great learning curve. The first year we produced 1,000 because it was quite difficult to learn how to culture them. Last year we released 635,000, so a target of over 1 million I think is achievable for this season.
Challenger Institute of Technology have cracked the code on how to culture and breed the Western school prawn.
So she'd be the type of animal that we would take back to the labs for Challenger to start to culture.
Right.
And she might have anywhere between 30,000 and 50,000 eggs in her.
With the help of the Swan River Trust and Murdoch University, a massive restocking program is taking place. Though some may have concerns about the health of the swan, authorities say those sweet little crustaceans are still fine to eat. And the dream to bring back that great Swan River tradition.
That would be great. I'm sure lots of people in Perth would be really excited if we could make that happen. This project, the culturing project, is a pilot project. We're doing it for about 3 years. We've had great success so far.
But there's still a long way to go, and volunteers are playing a crucial role in the research program by providing details of their prawning catches, and it can now be done with a new app.
Previously we do a lot of this sort of work with pen and paper, and now we're doing it more with the apps and with mobile phones, and all the phones have GPSs and cameras in, so we can get some really good data about what's been collected, and it really starts to help make a difference.
The Science Citizen Project is funded by money from the payment of recreational fishing licences to help revitalise and restore a unique Swan River pastime.
It was very much a family involvement era for catching prawns in the Swan River. So if we can get that back again, it'd be absolutely fantastic, and that's certainly how we'd measure it, of being a success.
Michael Thompson, Nine News.